sales coaches, training, all this stuff. They're going to preach. They're going to tell you about scripts, dialogues, objection handling. Anybody that's had a coach, that's all they've heard. Anybody who has dealt with any type of training, or if they've read anything online or even a YouTube article, it's always like scripts, dialogues, objection handling. Okay, that works in theory, but you have to. You're almost like a robot. If it works, I say A. If they say this, I say B. If they say this, it's very robotic. There's a system to it if you use them. I'm not a fan of them. So what I like to teach is that it's a framework that gets you to the same thing, but it allows you to free flow through the conversation, through the process, to be able to not only educate yourself, but be able to educate the people you're working with. Okay, this is the modern sales process. This is Coach David come up with this. He's been working with me for probably 4 or 5 years. And I've been recently training my personal real estate coaching clients with this. So I think it'd be good to start with you guys too. So with that being said, MSP is the modern sales process. There are several steps. Who's read the Way of the Wolf? I know you have.
The Way of the Wolf of Wall Street.
It's the same guy, Jordan Ralph. It's his way of selling. It's a cheesy way, you know, almost a cheesy way of selling, but it gets to the point really well the way he does it. So this is a lot off that as far as the way you come back around to things. When you get to certain issues, like what it tells me is if I'm traveling down the road and I'm looking for a sign that says, educate, turn here, and I don't see it, it's because I didn't qualify. I need to go back because I didn't hit the right place in the road. So that being said, build rapport. Build rapport is exactly what it is. Rapport is how you feel about me, how I feel about you, how you feel about the situation, how comfortable you are, what you think of me as a human being. So this comes in naturally. Like me and Lincoln could walk in the same time, same place, and just by, if I don't have my sales face on, like I'm immediately out of rapport. Because I'm not a social person, I'm not that friendly of a person, like exterior. I don't look that way. Lincoln does. Lincoln's always happy, smiling, he's a big goof. So he's obviously going to be in rapport faster. So just because he's smiling, so he's happy. This is a big thing. People want to do business with people who make them happy. People want to do business with people that are fun. People want to do business with people who are educated. So you have to be able to get all of this by building rapport. You build rapport by talking to people. Everybody has their favorite subject. What is their favorite subject?
Sales.
Self. People want to talk about their self. No matter what they are, if I'm talking about, hey man, your hair is so pretty today. She loves that too. Hey Dustin, sweet little speak. You know it's coming. In his defense, he corrected my spelling already, so he's basically showing off his third grade spelling.
Fifth.
Who turns your head? Bum Lincoln is getting discouraged. So rapport is built, rapport is kept. If I talk to Lincoln today and we build very good rapport and I follow up with him in 2 days, that doesn't mean that I'm always here. That may mean I may be here too. Like I have to redo this. So you always have to assess during the conversation of where you're at in the process. So you be friendly, small, keep the conversation on their favorite subject. Actively engage. Is basically, you heard of active listening. Like, mm-hmm, yeah, okay, that's active listening. Actively engaged listening is a little different. If I'm talking to Megan and she is talking about, I don't know, she wants a front porch. Okay, Megan, you want a front porch, why is that important to you? So I'm keeping her on conversation, I'm keeping her talking. I'm building rapport. And this also comes into qualifying. Qualifying is the process of me getting, it's not qualifying to see if they're ready, willing, and able. That's not what this is. Qualifying is I am allowing you to go deep. Like if Lincoln's digging a hole and he keeps digging it like 10 foot wide, he goes 3 inches deep, he keeps going wider and wider and wider, we're not getting any depth. So it's like you stay here, 2x2, and you go deep. So it's sort of the same thing when I'm qualifying. When I'm qualifying, I am finding out about them. I'm finding out about their needs. But what I'm focusing on the most is I'm focusing on what they're scared of. People will respond to fear way more than they respond to a
respond to fear way more. I can tell Dustin that I'm going to give him $100 or I'm going to punch him in the face. And the punch in the face will be what sticks out to him, even if he needs the money. It's just that always the fear. If you see, I'm doing a video today, and the video is, you should take advantage of this really hot real estate market because you get to capitalize on all this equity you created. And the video starts off with me saying, you're going to miss your window of opportunity to make the most amount of money you possibly can. And that instantly is going to engage everybody because they're like, well, I don't want to miss out. And so I get engaged their attention because everybody's telling them what they can do and what they can't. So I'm telling them what they're in fear of. So it's always really good. So when I qualify, I dig deep. So I'm talking to Lincoln. Lincoln's like, you know, I want a front porch.
Okay,
Lincoln, tell me about that. Why do you want a front porch? Lincoln telling me that through conversation, he's telling me he's going deep. And I'm like, okay, tell me more about that. Okay, that's good. That's interesting. You know, I'm actively engaged listening. So I'm talking about his favorite subject, what he wants to talk about. And I am constantly keeping him talking about it. So as I'm doing this, I'm also continuing to build rapport. People want to talk to me. Everybody's got that one friend that interrupts. Thing you say, he's always like this, always wants to say something. He's listening to respond. He's not listening to listen to you. And you hate talking to that person for that reason. So you're doing the exact opposite. You're listening to what they're saying. But basically, all the thing they're doing, when you keep talking, keep asking them questions, keep going deep enough, they're telling you everything that's bothering them about the situation of buying or selling a house. They're telling you. So I'm talking, I'm qualifying, and they're talking about buying and selling. You know, well, why does that scare you, Lincoln? And say, well, it scares me because the process can be hard, and what if I don't get what I'm asking? What if they come back and ask for a bunch of repairs? So I'm just listening. So why does that scare you? You know, tell me about that. Has this happened to you before? Tell me the stories. So he's telling me everything that bothers him about this process. So I get down to educate. And when I get educated, it's not like, Lincoln, this is how this works. Hey, Lincoln, I think you really need to talk about hiring temps, not associates. Because one thing we do is we take the stress away from you because we have a full team working in your favor at all times. So therefore, things don't fall through the cracks. And we're going to get multiple offers because we're going to list it at this price. And when I list it at multiple offers, we're going to get people to say they don't want to use their contingent. They're not going to do an inspection. We're going to get this. So basically, everything he told me that bothers him, when I'm educating him, my pitch, it's just like, this is what we do. So he's basically told me everything that he's scared of. And it just happens to be what we're really good at. Talking to people, and they're like, I took a listing in LaGrange, and the lady was like, well, you know, the last agent said they don't want to do open houses because it's a hassle. And I could see it in their eyes that they like the open houses. And they're talking, and she said two or three things. I said, well, I said, one thing about our team that you're not going to find with any other team around here. I said, we are a marketing-based business. As soon as I said it, the husband picked up. First time he picked up over his coffee cup the entire time. I said, what I mean by that, we put a lot of money into our marketing. It's my job to get as many people through this house as I possibly can. It's mine and your job to price it appropriately. And it's mine and your job to negotiate it to where we need to be. Because you know what your bottom dollar is, and my job is to get you as much as I can. Does that make sense? Yeah, it makes sense. I'm like, okay. So what we do different, first thing we did, we're going to run a bunch of traffic to get an open house here. And I'm going to have 50 people run through this open house, and I'm going to have them fighting over each other. And I'm telling him everything he sees on HGTV. So I'm feeding him up. Now he's looking at his life, but I told you that was how that happens. So now I already know who the decision maker is because of the previous conversation, so I know who I've got to sell to. So now he's hyped up about it. He's excited. And he's like, well, she said, would you like to know what the other lady said it would sell for? I'm like, absolutely. It's up for $330. She's lying. I said, it won't sell for $1 over $250. And he said, I told you. And then now they're like, well, we thought it was high. I was like, yeah. I said, here's what's going to happen. And then I explained the whole process of what she's going to do. Because I know that agent. She's going to price it high. She's going to come in 2 weeks. She's going to tell you what it's going to sell for. And she's going to absolutely have a buyer for it. No, she'll bring her own buyer and she'll make 50% and sell it for exactly what I told you to. But because she didn't price it appropriately, she's not going to drive the market up. Because I can take a home that's listed at $250, list it at $230, and have multiple offers and sell it at $270. You know what I mean? It's just because it's the way you do it, it's a strategy. So this is where I educate. Qualifies where I find out their questions, what they're having issues with. And when I educate, I come in and I handle everything they told me here. So if I get to here and then I can't convert, it's because I didn't qualify deep enough. It's still, there is something unknown that they're fear of, they're scared of. You can't ask them. If you ask them, they told you. You don't want them to tell you. You want them to tell you without telling you. So if I try to get here to go to here and I can't, it tells me I don't stay here. I don't continue to educate. I qualify. I go back to asking questions. I go back to finding out what their issues were. And then I come back to educate. And then I work to convert. So once I feel like I've handled all of Lincoln's objections and the things that he's dealing with, because I don't want to handle an objection. An objection is this. An objection is like, well, this is the answer. It's like you play a know-it-all. You always got one friend that knows everything. That's what an objection is. Like, they handle objection, they're head-to-head. They're going back and forth on what's going on here. So what I'd rather handle that nonchalantly, like without even you knowing I'm doing it, because I'm qualified well, I'm able to come through and educate there. So I go to convert. When you convert, you use tie downs. Tie downs are, the more times I can get you to say yes, the more likely you are to say yes. So Lincoln, from what I hear, you definitely want an open house. You want it to be seamless. You want to sell fast and for top dollar, but you don't want a big hassle. Yes, that's exactly what I want. Because of me explaining to you what my team does, we answer all the questions. So if my team handles every one of those things, it only makes sense that we work together. Wouldn't you agree? So I'm saying things like this. I'm saying things that he cannot logically say no to because it makes sense. Here's your fact. Here's the answer. Does that make sense? Yes. Because it's his facts and it's his answer. It's not mine. Because I've been able to qualify and educate, and I've already built rapport, so there's some sort of trust there. He's able to understand where I'm coming from. So you don't want an open house because, you know, you've got a lot of expensive things here. You've got guns and stuff, and it makes you uncomfortable if there's a bunch of people running through the house. Is that correct? Yes, that's absolutely right. I'll tell you what. Let me do an open house, and I'm going to have four agents. I'll have an agent in every room to make sure nothing happens. That way we can still make sure we're getting top dollar for you. How does that sound? Well, I like that. You know, nobody said they could do that. Most people don't have that big of a team, but that's the reason we do it. We're all special, so I'm able to continue to sell. So if we know that an open house is going to get you top dollar, and we know that you're scared of having an open house because of obvious reasons, you've got a lot of expensive stuff here, and I completely understand. I always side with them. It's never me against them. It can be here, it can be here. This is how you fight. You can fight going forward, or you fight each other. You never want to fight. You always want to align with them. So I'm like, and this is how we can handle that. And that would be probably the best way to get you more money. Wouldn't you agree? Like, yes. I'm like, okay. So it only makes sense for us to do that. Would you agree? Yes. We should sign papers today so we can get started on marketing tomorrow. Okay. So the more of these yes is the conversion. This is the land. This is the island. This is the bridge. The convert is that. The convert is how you get to the bridge. So you've got to be able to ask these tie down questions, just basic questions. Like, here's your problem. Here's a solution. Your problem. I am the solution. We should do this. It makes sense for us to move forward. Don't you think it makes sense for us to work together? I think it makes a lot of sense. What about you? So it's questions that they're going to say yes to. That's the only thing you're going to get to. So when you convert, and then the close is, and the close doesn't have to be signed here. The close could be something as simple as, well, man, is it okay if I follow up you tomorrow about the houses I'm going to send you? Yes, that is a close. Because the way... The process of close, people fall in your pipeline a little bit at a time. So this is the beginning, and this is the close. So it runs. So here you probably can't even see that, but that's where it's running, beginning close. People, there are different types of resources. You've got like Google pay-per-clicks. These are horrible. These are here. They're in the very beginning. You get Zillow leads, Realtor.com leads, they pop in right here. You get a referral, they're popping in here. And every now and then you get the guy and be like, I'm gonna see this house, this is what I wanna pay for it, and I'm pre-approved. So this guy falls in right here. So everybody falls in the process a little bit different. These are, oh, you know, this is, people fall into the process a little different. So what you've gotta do is, this is the same line as this. So as I'm moving him down the line, so say we're starting here with Joe. My first close with Joe is, I'm going to send you some properties. We're going to do this. Is it okay if I follow up to you tomorrow to see what you thought of the properties? Absolutely. So that's the close. So we move here. We're moving a little further down the line. But my focus is to continue to move Joe down the line. I find out if he likes the properties. Would you like to see the property? I'm not sure. Why don't you come into the office? That way we can look at everything on the MLS so we can sort of narrow down what you want. Okay, I like that. So I move with him further down the line and get to the close. And all I'm going to do with every conversation is move somebody one step further down the line. The further I move them down the line, the bigger my pipeline gets. The bigger the pipeline gets, the more I close in 6 to 8 weeks. But it's really important that every conversation moves you further down the line. And if you get to a spot where you can't move down, just know you're either out of rapport, you've not qualified enough, or you've not educated enough. And educated is not telling. That's what we've got to really understand. educating someone is me not telling Lincoln how it works, how he's wrong, how I'm right. People don't care. People don't care who you are. They don't care what you did. They only care about what you could do for them. So we find out their issues, and we give them their solutions, and it just happens to be what we happen to do. And your solutions are going to be different for everybody. Like sometimes people will be like, well, I don't want nobody to know I'm selling my house. So actually, I work with a lot of luxury clients who don't want the neighbors to want to know they're selling. So this is what we do differently. And this is now I've got a solution for them. And now they think I've did it before. I've got experience with it. And it's just to qualify, because I'm in rapport. You do not have permission to qualify until you build rapport. And this is hard. A lot of times this runs in together. A lot of times this little gray area runs together. Like I can still be qualifying you while I'm building rapport. And I can be building rapport while I'm qualifying and so forth and so forth. All this, they're always gray area. And it's okay to be inside the gray area as long as you're working down the funnel. Because this is where the funnel is. And there's a lot of people, like if this was a true funnel, this is a true funnel. There's more that comes into the top that you build rapport with, and then it comes down to the close. So, you know, if there's 100 people that started to build rapport, only 10 is going to get to close. So you've got to be able to work from build rapport to qualified, educated, convert to close. You've got to work them down the funnel, and you do that by having this in mind that every time, how do I get them further down the line? How do I get further down the line? How do I get further down the line? Because what was a, because everybody's like, you need to work with your A buyers, ready, willing, and able. That's great, but now that's not an A buyer. An A buyer now, someone ready, willing, and able, and will pay over asking price. Some people won't do that. Some people ready, willing, and able, but they're still looking for a deal. That is now a B buyer. That is not an A buyer. That is someone that does not get your front attention. Someone who, then you've got to make limits to those guys, the ones that don't want to pay asking price. Those are the houses, okay, so every house we look at needs to be on the market for at least 21 days. We can't look at new houses and come out with those offers, and this is why. And you may have to show them a couple of them to find out, and then you do it. And then their standards will change, and then you can adjust from there. They're going to decide it's not their time to buy, or they're going to be like, I'm willing to pay over asking for this one. They're going to miss a couple. So ready, willing, able, someone's willing to pay over. So that's exactly what it is, that person that gets most of your attention. And then you go to your B buyers, gets most of your attention. But every conversation, your conversation with your A buyers are, how do I get you looking right now? Your B buyer is, how do I get you ready to look? How do I get you pre-approved? Or whatever the next step is, C buyer. So my whole goal is A, B, C, D. Take D's to C's to B's to A's, and A's to close. That's your whole conversation. And you always start closest to the money. When you come in here and you're starting to dial at 9 o'clock, you immediately start with people looking at houses now. Hey Lincoln, I just sent you another property that I think would match your search criteria. Okay, great. Okay, Lincoln's getting the same notifications you are. He signed up on Zillow, Realtor.com, everywhere else. So what you've got to do, you've got to be creative. Hey Lincoln, I know you're looking for a 4-bedroom, 2-bath. I found a 3-bedroom with a bonus that suits exactly what you're looking for. It's a little bit out of your criteria, but I think it could work. I'll send it to you, let me know if you want to see it. So now that guy's like, this guy's doing more than Zillow and Realtor.com is. So now I've been able to build rapport, and I'm able to qualify and help build rapport because I've listened to everything he needs. So now I'm coming out of the box, which is what people need. Right now we are overpaid door openers writing overpriced offers. There's very little value that us as realtors are adding to the market right now. We have to know that. On the buying side, on the listing side, it works. Like it's right now, like I did a video the other day, people are, for 5 years I was the guy who sold it faster for top dollar than everybody. Statistics, I showed up, this is 106% above list price, I'm 60% faster days on market, and I can show everybody this, and now everybody can sell the fast $1. So now it's like I come in and I'm running the comps and I'm like, okay, well the highest price per square foot is $150 square foot. So what we're going to do, we'll list you at $145 square foot, I'll jack up the price and we're going to sell it for this. And the last one I did it for, we sold it for $166 square foot, which is considerably more than the last one I sold. So now my marketing is like, I know your agent can sell it fast and top dollar. They're doing it all over the place. But I'm the only agent selling it for max price. I got them what they deserved, not what they think it's worth. And now I got the statistics to do it. So I'm having to edge my marketing because of that. But you do that, but I'm able to do that because I've built rapport with people on social media, with my followers. But you gotta qualify. So ask the questions, get them digging deep. Let them tell you what their issues are. Don't assume their issues because you don't have a damn clue. And the second you assume, you're out of rapport and they're in someone else's pipeline. Because when they go this way, that's exactly where they go, in someone else's pipeline. And don't fool yourself into thinking that your client is just your client. Your client's talking to two or three other agents. Just know that the one that provides them the most value is the one that's going to get the sale. If you're just waiting around letting them look on Zillow, you're going to get shit. You don't deserve it. But know that's happening. Know they're constantly looking. We did open house this weekend. Buyer came in, wrote an offer, above asking price offer. And I mean, it's like literally, it's probably $41,000 it's going to appraise for. But when you put an offer on my list, you have to show proof of that you're going to pay the difference. You have to pay the difference. I don't care what it appraises for. So this guy came in, the agent called. He goes, "Hey, Tim, that's my client." We got a buyer brokerage now. Me too. And the buyer brokerage between you and you have an end up doing me. So take it up with him. You're not doing your job. Like, I'm not. You know what I mean? I'm that's not my fault you can't do your job. That's the reason all the agents love me. But it's the truth. It's like, I'm not willing to do that. It's like, well, I'm not a referral fee or nothing. I'm like, no. It ain't my problem. It's your problem. And that's how you have to think as far as moving forward. Is you, what is the issue? And these clients are talking to more than one agent. Who's going to bring them the deal? Who's going to do above and beyond? And now we're seeing even up here, we see a lot of them going to the listing agent anyway. Back home, it don't happen. Everybody has representation. But we're seeing a lot more of it. So just understand that's how that works. What are your questions with the modern sales process? The build rapport is when you align with them. You're on a team. It's not this. Because this is how they see you in the beginning. You've got to align with them. And you align with them in conflict. And I see this happen with real estate agents all the time. Barney, Matt. If I'm talking to Matt, and Matt confronts me, and Matt says, you know, I don't feel like you're working hard enough for me. This is now a conflict. So I have to be able to pivot and be like, I know exactly how you feel. There's not a lot on the market. Sometimes I feel like I'm not doing enough for you. But I need you to know that I'm working as hard as I can for you. This is why. I've got to be able to align with him immediately. Because the second I start questioning and challenging him, it's this.
Yeah.
People do not want to work with this. People want to work with this. They want to work with somebody that's fighting for them. You have to let them know. So anytime a conflict arises, same thing working with other agents. You know, they're going to be pissed. They're going to be upset. You didn't accept their offer. And I'm be like, tell you the truth, Lincoln, I fought for your offer. Because I've worked with you before. And I love the way you do business. And you handle things like you're supposed to. The truth is, they're just looking at their top dollar. Now I just made him feel great because, again, I'm in rapport because I talked about his favorite subject and stroked his ego. So now he's excited. You know what I mean? He feels better. He's not excited because he less missed out on commission. But now he's excited. So you've got to be able to pivot when that happens. And the same way, anytime conflict happens, you're stepping back. So what I want you to remember, you have to be in rapport. You have to ask great questions. Keep the subject on themselves. Educate them on what they tell you they want educated on, because they're not going to come out and tell you. You're going to figure it out by asking great questions. You educate them, and then you work on convert, and you convert with tie-downs. Tie-downs, you ask questions that they can't say no to, that wouldn't make sense to say no to. I mean, you like coffee, I like coffee. We should have coffee. Yes, we should. I mean, that's it. I don't like coffee. Like, man, 1 minute ago you said you like coffee. Like, that's it. I'm married. Bring your wife. You know, it's whatever. So in close, the close is the natural thing that happens between educating close and conversion. And remember, a close isn't a contract sign. A close can be any step that happens from the beginning to the close. Such questions. If you don't ask, you don't know. That's going to bring this crank on.
Did you get shot in this?
Notes. You probably did if you didn't eat them before class.
I don't have any questions, but
does it make sense?
Yeah.
Like, makes sense.
I really like you talking about just deflecting, because a lot of times ego will cause you to kind of stand out. But well, I've been doing everything, you know. Instead
ego
of just
is not your ego.
Idiot, appealing to me.
Neither is Matt.
I'm stepping to the side and just being pissed at others.